Okay, let's do this. Hey, what's up everyone? This is Push for Life and welcome to the next video tutorial. I'm really excited about this one because I've decided to do a new series, basically where I take beats that I like, past and present and across all genres, and I deconstruct them and then reconstruct them. Now, a few of you may or may not know, but I am a professional drummer by trade. So what we're going to do is, because we're specifically looking at beats in this tutorial series, what I will be doing is I'm going to take the beats from the particular tracks, I'm going to deconstruct them on my drum kit so you can see from a drummer's perspective what's going on, how it's put together on a kit. Then I'm going to write it down in music notation, but don't worry if you don't understand music notation, I'm going to use a simplified version that I use when I teach as well for people who've never used music notation before. I'm going to write it down so you can see how it's constructed on paper, because a lot of times that will make it a lot easier to understand the beat, what's going on, etc. And then once we've done that, we've deconstructed on the kit, we wrote it down in music notation, then we're going to take all of that knowledge, that broader context from a drummer's perspective, and then we're going to sit down on our beautiful Ableton pushes, and then we're going to reconstruct the beat in the step sequencer and basically build it right back up. And hopefully you'll have a really good idea of what's going on in the beat, why certain things are the way they are. Then what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to make variations on that beat so you can basically start building your own beats based on tracks that you like. There is a download link in the description, so make sure to click that and download some goodies that are related to that particular tutorial. One thing I would like to point out though is that this is not a sound design class, so we're not going to be reconstructing the overall sound design of a particular beat. It's all about how is the rhythm put together and what makes it the rhythm that it is. Enough talking, let's get to the kit. We're going to be working on Can't Feel My Face from The Weeknd, one of my favorite tracks at the moment, and let's get right to it. There are only going to be 5 sounds we're going to be using. So first of all, we've got the bass drum, we've got the snare drum, we've got a closed hi-hat, open hi-hat, and we have a crash cymbal. So on the Ableton push, we're only going to be using 5 sounds in the drum rack later on. All right, so let me just play the rhythm for you on the kit as it is on the track. Here we go. And that's it. So I'm going to break it down into 3 parts. First of all, there's just the basic beat, and that goes like this. Okay, that's pretty straightforward, and as you'll see, it's very easy to program this beat on Ableton Push. The second part of the beat is we have an open hi-hat. Oh, first of all, I should actually explain. The beat as a whole is a 4-bar beat. So what I basically played to you there was the first bar. The second bar of the beat has an open hi-hat on the 4 and. So I'm just going to play the second bar right now. That's pretty straightforward too. It's basically the first beat with an open hi-hat on the four. And then in bar four, there's a small, tiny little fill on the bass drum and the snare drum. And let me just play it really slowly. This is bar four. It goes like this. Okay, let me do it again. I'll do it really, really slow. Okay, so that's basically the beat. And then as part of the whole four bar loop, there's a crash on beat one of bar one. So if I play the whole beat quite slowly, this is what it sounds like. And that's it. So, like I said to you before, I'm going to write it down as music notation now, and then you'll really see how simple this beat is going to be to program on Ableton Push 2. Here we go. So this is something that I prepared earlier. It's just for those of you who don't really understand how music notation works. So the basic grid of this track is in 16th notes, which is great for what we're doing on Ableton Push, because in the step sequencer, which I've made this diagram of, the top row are beats 1 and beat 2, and the second row are beat 3 and beat 4 of bar 1. So this is what one bar of 16th notes looks like. Here we have, the way you count, actually, let me start off with this. The way you count 16th notes are 1E and 2E and 3E and 4E and the way that's laid out on the push is 1E and as you can see here with the colors, 2E and which are the green ones, 3E and 4E and which correspond to beat 3 and beat 4. And that's all you really need to know in terms of how 16th notes are laid out on Ableton Push. So like I said, Can't Feel My Face is in a 16th note grid, so I'm going to write out the music notation using these 16th notes, okay? So take one more good look at this for those of you who don't understand music notation very well. And as you can see now, what I have done is I've written out the 16th notes like this. This is going to make a lot more sense in just a second. So this is 1E and 2E and 3E and 4E and these basically belong together. You'll see how this works right now. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to take a pen and just quickly write down the track name, and this is basically bar 1. So I'm just going to write bar 1 here. This is all going to be relevant once we sit down on our pushes. So the next part you need to understand is these lines right here, they represent basically the instruments of the drum kit that we are going to be using. So remember when I was on the drum kit, I showed you the different instruments we used. I'm going to write these down on the lines here. So this very bottom line right here is going to be our bass drum. This second line right here is going to be our snare drum. The third line right here is going to be our closed hi-hat. So I'm just going to write C hi-hat. This middle line right here is going to be our open hi-hat. And the top line right here is going to be our crash cymbal. Okay? So I'm going to use a red pen right now to write out the music notation. So first of all, I'm going to write out the hi-hats. The closed hi-hats in bar 1 are basically on every second 16th note. So that would be this one, this one, and that one. And for those of you that understand a little bit of music theory, the hi-hat is playing eighth notes. So I'm just going to write that out here. And typically, as a drummer, the hi-hat is written with X's, okay? So like I said, this is all going to make a lot more sense in just a moment when I sit down with these various notations on Ableton Push. All right, so let me just take a black pen and extend these. Okay, so that's the eighth notes right there. Then we also have the crash cymbal on beat one of bar one. So I'm just going to put that in there, like so. And now that's all we need on those lines in bar one. And then we have the bass drum and snare drum. So the bass drum is right here on beat one, the first 16th note of beat one. And then we have the snare drum on beat two, another bass drum on the fourth 16th note of beat two, like that, on the three, and then another snare drum on the four. Let me just extend these. Here we go. There we go. So that's basically bar one of our four-bar loop of Can't Feel My Face. So take one good look at that. And like I said, I'm going to be using these when we sit down on our pushes in one moment. So let's do bar two. Let me just stick this in here. All right, so the hi-hat pattern is basically the same in bar two, eighth note, so every second one, apart from the four and, which is an open hi-hat. So I'm just going to remember bar the middle line right here is the open hi-hat. So I'm just going to write that in right here, right now. And when drummers write down music notation, the open hi-hat usually has a circle around it like that. So let's put in the other hi-hats like this. Okay, let's just extend those. So, the bass drum and snare drum pattern are the same. So we have this, beat one, beat two is like this, beat three and beat four. There we go, just extend those to make it look nice and pretty. And that's basically bar two. Then we have bar three, which is practically the same as bar one, except there's no crash cymbal on beat one. So let's put in those hi-hats like this. And bass drum and snare drum are also the same. So, just extend those again. And now we have beat four that has the little fill-in at the end. Let me just put that over here. Here we go. All right, so bar four, hi-hats are the same, eighth notes. And we have an open hi-hat, as in the second bar, on the four and again. There we go. So, up, whoops. Sorry about that, camera. Let's make sure that it's okay. Little mistake on my behalf, excuse that. So, really, basically, up until beat three, everything's the same. So let's just do that right now. This is where things change up a bit. We have two bass drums right here on the three and the three and, and usually we'd have the snare on the 4, which we do here, but there's also a snare right here on the 4th 16th note of beat 3, and that is basically our fill-in. All right, and there we have it. That's basically the music notation of Can't Feel My Face by The Weeknd. So let's get right to programming this into our Ableton Push. So here's just one very quick reminder of how we relate the 16th notes to our Ableton Push. So obviously this right here is what you see right here. So the first set of 16th notes are one iande, which is this first part of the top row, one iande. Two iande, which is two iande. Three iande, three iande, and four iande, which is here. So that's bar one, those first two rows. Bar two are the second two rows, okay? So that's just a quick recap, and now we're going to get straight to business and try to get this programmed in as efficiently as possible. All right, so let's take our track sheets right here. So remember, we're just going to program in bar one for now, and we're going to start off with the hi-hats. So we have the hi-hats on every second 16th note for the whole bar. Okay, so what we're going to do first of all is I'm going in Ableton itself, I'm going to double click in right here, and that's going to create a one bar loop. We're basically going to recreate bar one of our four bar loop right now. Okay, so like I said, it's the every second 16th note for the hi-hat. So it's one E and two E and three E and four E and. There we go. So if I push play right now, that's one and two and three and four and. That was super easy. Then we have the crash cymbal on beat one. So we select our crash cymbal right here, and I just whack that in right there. Then we have the snare on the 2 and the 4, right? So this is my snare, and here is beat 2 and beat 4. So let's just see how that sounds. That's really nice. And now we just have to program in the bass drum, which is the first 16th of beat 1, the fourth 16th of beat 2, the first 16th of beat 3, and that's it. So let's select our bass drum. Here is the first 16th of beat 1, the fourth 16th of beat 2, and the first 16th of beat 3. And let's see how that sounds. And there we have the entire bar one of our loop. So what we're going to do now, like I said, we want to do this as efficiently as possible, and Ableton has this really, really great function, double loop. And what that's going to do, when I hit this button, if you check out here, this is a one bar loop right now, and when I hit double loop, it's basically going to create a two bar version of the one bar loop that we just programmed. So bar two, which is this section, is exactly the same as bar one. So what we need to do is we have a four bar loop. So I'm going to hit that one more time. And now we have four bars basically of this entire pattern right here, which is bar one. Now obviously we have changes to make, but the bass drum pattern, for instance, is the exact same pattern all the way through bar three. The hi-hat pattern is pretty much the same apart from a few open hi-hats, and the crash cymbal is only on bar one. So we need to do some editing right now, but we can work really, really quickly and efficiently. So let's get rid of this page right here. Okay, so let's go to bar two. So I'm going to double click here, and now you can see in Ableton it's opened up bar two. So the first thing we want to do is we want to edit out the crash cymbal that is here That's a remainder of bar one. I'm just going to double click on that. Now that is gone. And the only difference here, like I said before, in bar two, is that on the four and we don't have a closed hi-hat, but we have an open hi-hat. Whoops, let me just double click that again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this closed hi-hat and just move it up a notch, and now it should be on an open hi-hat. So let's just see how that sounds now. Great, right? So we basically didn't have to program in anything else there. That's bar two. So now we're going to work on bar three. And bar three is exactly the same as bar one, as you can see right here, except that the crash cymbal isn't there. So I'm just going to double click again on the third bar. And all I have to do now is go in and double click on the cymbal here. And we have bar three programmed in. That was easy, right? And now let's move on to bar four. Now bar four is a little different, I have to say, and that's mainly because of this fill-in. So what we have to do now is, I'm just going to double click here on bar four. Now there's no crash cymbal, as you can see right here. So let's first of all edit out that crash cymbal. Then, so beat one is the same, beat two is the same, beat three, we have an extra bass drum on the third 16th note of beat three. So let's see, here's beat three right here. So let's just double click and add a bass drum right there. And we have another snare drum on the fourth 16th of beat three. So let's just add one right here. And now all we have to do is move that closed hi-hat up to an open hi-hat. So here's the closed hi-hat right here. And let's just move it up there. And let's see how that sounds. And there we have it. So we basically programmed in that four bar loop within just a few minutes. And now I'm going to select the entire thing by holding down this pad and clicking on that pad. And let's just see how the whole thing sounds. And there you have it. We basically programmed it in. That was really, really simple, as you can see. Push is so great when it comes to stuff like this. And that's the beat. So let's see how it sounds with the original track. Let me just let it run through once. Go on mix here. And let's turn up the original track. I can feel my face when I'm with you. But I love it. But I love it. Oh, I can feel my face. There you have it. That's the beat right there. So as I promised, I'm just going to program in a couple of other variations just so you can see how you can take a beat, program it out yourself, and then just start messing around with it on your push and creating completely different beats. So all right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the beat we just programmed, I'm going to alt click it and just drag it down here, and I'm going to create a variation on this one. As you can see on this right here, we have an open hi-hat on the four and. So what I'm going to do is I'm basically going to take this pattern and I'm going to put it throughout all four bars. So what we're going to do is we're going to go onto our hi-hats here. So this is basically the and of all of the bars. So I'm just going to deselect those and do the same for bars three and bars four. I just missed one right there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go on the open hi-hat. That one's already selected, so let's just select the ones above it and do the same right here and do the same over here. And let's just see how this variation sounds. Oh, hold on. I need to push play. That was just playing the original clip. Let's play this clip that I just programmed in. Oh, here we go. Another little mistake. Let's select all of those and play it again. That's a nice little variation. And let me just create one more where we really sort of shake things up a little. We double click on this. What I'm going to do here is I'm just going to add some different bass drums. I'll do that here too. And I'm going to move the snare on beat 2 over to the 2 and. And let's just see how that sounds. This should be quite different than the original groove, but it's still based on the original groove. Let's see how this one sounds. Maybe let's add some more snares over here. Let's take that one away and just make like a proper long 16th fill in on beat 4 of bar 4. Let's just see how that sounds. And there you have it. So we basically created the original beat, and then we took it and just started messing around with different parts of the pattern and created completely new beats based on a song that we really like. So that's a great way of coming up with new beats, is going through the tracks that you like, trying to recreate the grooves, and then messing with them just ever so slightly, just tweaking them here and there, and all of a sudden you'll see you've come up with an entirely new groove based on something that you really like. And that's just a nice way of creating a little beat workflow. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. I really, really hope you enjoyed it. Like I said at the beginning, this is an experiment, so I would really appreciate it if you leave me a comment below. Let me know if you like this type of thing. If there are enough comments of people who like it, I will definitely look into doing more of this type of tutorial. I have quite a few different ideas for different tutorials, so the more feedback you guys give me on what you like or dislike, the more I know how I can sort of cater to your needs, because that's what I'm here for. Also, remember, there are files. You can get this project file that we've been working on right here with the variations that you can use to your heart's content. The download link is in the description box. Make sure to get those files. I'll also include PDFs of the beats that we wrote down for this particular track. Please make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy what I do, because that is going to keep me motivated to keep putting out content if I know that people are watching and liking what I'm doing. Also, make sure to check out my website, pushforlife.eu, for, you know, just staying up to date with what I'm doing, because I post on Instagram, I post here, and post to various other places, and it all comes together at pushforlife.eu. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be uploading some more content very, very soon. All the best for now. Take care.